you're able to read in between the lines, then I think you're mature enough. If not, I think there is always next time and you'll get well soon. Don't worry about it. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to Creator on Wheels. I'm Shiv and I hope you guys are doing happy and healthy. It's 14th of January 2022. The first month of this new year is already half gone. Time just flies by. Alright, so what we're going to do today is talk about a very interesting thing that happened yesterday. Okay, so three new bikes were launched and we're going to talk about it very briefly, and I'm gonna give my personal opinion about these three bikes, their looks, their configuration and whatsoever. And for those of you people who have been living under the rocks and don't know what really happened in the last maybe like 24 or 36 hours, a company which has been pretty well known for reviving old motorcycle brand, of which this is one of them, has revived one more brand and launched three new motorcycles under that brand. And I got to outright say, those three motorcycles have been very inspired copy from existing bikes, very popular existing bikes, I would say. So that's exactly what we're going to talk about. And the new brand, or the three new motorcycles that we're talking about today, are the SD Roadster, SD Scrambler and the SD Adventure. Yes, it's the SD, which is the 2.0 of Java, which is now being relaunched by Classic Legends Private Limited. And under this banner, or under this brand as they would like to call it, they are released three so-called new motorcycles. And is it really new? That's something which people can answer themselves. I need not emphasize anything on it, because these three new motorcycles are using the exact same old 334cc liquid cooled single cylinder engine from the Parak, the Java Parak. So they have released three bikes with different tunings, different type of look and feel, I would call, and priced it almost similarly, and they want to call it as brand new bikes. Okay, let's talk about it. So all these three bikes, as I told you, are carrying forward the same 334cc approximately 30 PS powered Java Parak engine. But according to the company, they have tuned each and every of these three bikes differently, so that it behaves differently, and so that people can assume that these are three different bikes. And the way the suspension setups are done, the way the tires are, the way the ground clearance is, the way the seats are, everything is different except for the engine. So that's kind of like a higher level summary. Now going a little bit more granular, what really is happening here is the SD Roadster is more of like a commuter or road focused bike, and that's kind of like a crossover between Java and the SD. They are trying to see if they can do something like what happened in the past to replicate that now. And the Scrambler is more of like a tarmac, slightly off-road, go-anywhere kind of a bike. And the last one, the Java Adventure, sorry, the SD Adventure, is 100% what they would like to call it as, like an adventure touring kind of a bike. Now, talking about the inspiration part, let me get that point clear straight away. For the people who have seen RE Meteor 350, I'm pretty sure the Yes, the Roadster looks no different. For the people who have seen Triumph Scrambler, okay, the bar is slightly higher here. Yes, the Scrambler looks no different. And for the people who have seen Himalayan, the Adventure looks no different. In fact, the Scrambler and the Adventure, some of the paint schemes have been exact replica of what are in their competitive companies. Like, that's something which is really what you can call it as lack of innovation or lack of thinking or whatever you can call it. But some of the paint schemes are even the exact same as what is there in their competitive brands, I would say. Now, coming to these three bikes, as I told you, the Roadster is more of like a city or commute or slightly higher powered bike for city usage, I would say, 334cc. It is tuned more of for the city usage or commute usage. It has a kind of a balanced 18-17 kind of a wheel, a decent suspension setup, and kind of, I would say, like a cruiser format seat, the scoop seat kind of what you can see, or people used to call it like a sofa seat here a few years back, that kind of a seat. So it's more of like a relaxed cruiser kind of a configuration. If you see the body panel, the design, everything, it's almost the Java 42. Okay, the side panel, the tank, so kind of like everything looks like the Java 42 itself. It's just the color schema that is different and few things which have been tweaked here and there aesthetically to make it look new. Speedo console for all three bikes are different or new. It's all digital now. It's all LED headlights now. The Speedo is almost same on the Roadster and Scrambler, but on the Adventure, they have added the navigation feature and try to make it look different by putting it in a square plastic box with two circular cutout holes. Coming back to Roadster, as I told you, it's almost like a Java 42 itself, but slightly higher powered. And color combinations or look and feel wise, I don't see any difference at all. Now, I'll talk about my personal opinion about all these things just in a little while, but let me talk about the three bikes. Now, coming to the Scrambler, this I would personally say is slightly unique because there isn't any 300-350cc kind of a Scrambler in market at all. So it's a very niche market, because the nearest Scrambler what is there right now in market are from companies like Ducati and Triumph, and they are like super heavily priced, and these are like premium bikes. Those are not entry level bikes. So this is more of like a entry into the Scrambler segment. Here the tires, the suspension is slightly different. It's slightly more travel, slightly bigger front tires with 19-17 combination, different handle, kind of like with a motocross style bar in between, different kind of mirrors, and what else is different in this? The ground clearance is definitely different. The tires are different. In fact, this is more of like a on-road, off-road kind of a tire that is there. The ground clearance is a lot better. I would not say a lot better, rather I would say this is different. The seat height is different compared to the Roadster. The Roadster is the one which has the least seat height and the least ground clearance. And then next up is our Scrambler, which has slightly better seat height and a ground clearance increase of about, it's about 20 mm increase. So that's where the Scrambler sits. Next is the Adventure. The Adventure. So this is the one which looks totally different. This is the one which looks different from the other two bikes. I'm not telling about comparison with Himalayan. Okay, it looks exactly like the Himalayan. Let me be clear about it. Except for the tank, it's almost like it's very easy for people to mistake RE Himalayan with the SD Adventure. Now this has a totally different type of body geometry. It has a split seat just like the Himalayan. It has a longer travel suspension just like the Himalayan. It has a bigger front wheel, 21-inch, just like the Himalayan. It has a very good ground clearance, just like the Himalayan. But it has a very good or a better powered engine, which is not like the Himalayan. So compared to what a Himalayan is, which is 411cc and a 24 PS powered vehicle, the ESD Adventure is about 334cc and 30 PS power. So on paper, it looks extremely competitive, but does it perform really well? That is something which time will tell and automobile reviewers will tell. Let me make one thing very clear. I'm not an automobile reviewer. I'm not an expert. I don't come from automobile engineering background. So there are better people out there whose words you can listen to. There are better influencers out there who are ready to convince you, and there are better fanboys out there who are ready to talk about these three bikes and how awesome these three new bikes are. So that's exactly what these three bikes are. So when it comes to specs, I think I'll put something on the screen here wherein you can see the comparison between Roadster, Scrambler and the Adventure, so what differentiates each of them. And pricing wise, all of them are almost same. The Roadster is about 1.9 lakhs ex-showroom Delhi. The Scrambler is about 2 lakhs and the Adventure is about 2.1 lakhs. These are all Delhi prices. I tried to get in touch with few folks from Bangalore. What I've been told is that the Bangalore price is not confirmed yet. That I found it a little bit strange and dumb, because during the launch ceremony yesterday, they were telling that the bikes are available now in the showrooms all across India, the so-called 300 showrooms, and the delivery will start immediately. But today being the second day after the launch, I'm not sure what more are they waiting for to get the pricing and all those stuff. So that's about the pricing part. They're like, I'm expecting it to land somewhere around 2.5 lakhs when it comes to the pricing here in Bangalore, or maybe slightly more. If I'm able to get the exact prices before I publish this video, I'll put them on the screen. If not, I don't think so. It's really rocket science for you to figure out what, why, where, when, about all the pricing. Okay, and all these things are for the base models. Okay, so when I say base model, we are not talking about any accessories or anything like that. We are talking about exact base model, and probably just like few other companies, like few other car companies, I would say, here again, pricing might or will change based on the color also. So probably you might want to look up before you figure out which color you want to buy and what is the price and if it is in your budget and if this is a right bike. That is something you need to find out yourself. Okay. Now let's move on to the key part of this video, which is me telling what my first impression or what is my opinion about these three bikes and what do I feel about it, considering the fact that I have a little bit of authority that I've been owning and riding a Java 42 generation 1 bike since the last 2+ years, and I've been seeing what's happening in this whole world of Java motorcycles and classic legends and how they treat their customers and how is their customer service in the service centers, everything. I have like a first-hand experience, and I'm taking this liberty to talk my heart out regarding this and what they have done as a company. My first point here: I'm not at all impressed about all these three bikes. Absolutely not. I mean, I don't see anything which makes me feel very excited or happy about these three bikes. I mean, there are so many bike launches that happen throughout the year, and this is probably one of the low profile ones because they don't look new, the engine isn't new, and historically there hasn't been anything new or good about this whole brand thing. Okay, that's my first point. Second thing, as I told you, I personally own and ride a first generation Java, which I think maybe you can call it the BS6 compliant version, and it's a 2019 model what I've been running, and this is not the BS6. So there has been two iterations of the Java motorcycles over the last 2 years. First is in it was in April of 2020 that the BS6 was launched. Not much of a change when it comes to the look and feel or anything on the mechanical side, just the BS6 version. And 2021 is when the Java 2.1 was released. There were few changes. Blacked out engine cases, blacked out silencer, the so-called slightly tuned ground clearance, maybe like they called it like a tuned suspension, because of which there was a better ground clearance, better seat, and most importantly, the alloy wheels, which in turn meant that the folks can go ahead and use tubeless tires on their Java motorbike. So there were three new colors, white, red and black, which was launched along with this. And the existing bikes, the ones, the BS6 versions, they were also given the option of taking the alloy wheels or any of the new accessories, not the blacked out engine anything, but at least that alloy wheels or windscreen and such things came up there. So in between all these things, every single one of these Gen 1 and Gen 2 Java 42 owners, I'm specifically talking about Java 42, I'm not even talking about the classic, because it's exactly the same, but the way it looks, the way it is supposed to look, the classic vintage look, let's not bring it into picture here. We're specifically talking about the Gen 1 and Gen 2 Java 42. Most of the folks who, including me, who had issues with the seat, or who had issues with the ground clearance, or who had issues with whatsoever with the bike, like the riding triangle, the handlebar, everything, most of them took the liberty to do a hell lot of experiments with their bike to make it suit their need. I mean, that's, I would not say that is how the bike should have been initially, but they modified it the way they want. Like, I have my own setup wherein I'm riding now with a Farrakh handle, and in past I've experimented with two or three different handles, and there were plus and minus of all of them. The seats is something which was terribly awful, and I had changed it. I think I had got it updated in the very first week of me purchasing my bike. The ground clearance was so horrible that every single person had like his or her own theory about how to negate this. One is higher air pressure, and some people were talking about suspension raising and all those things. I personally have a raised or a modified back suspension, which has totally negated this ground clearance issue for me. But so many things were done. Now, that was all mechanical part. Like, some people wanted the looks part of it. Okay, in between all these things, there is also touring stuff. A lot of people got touring accessories done, touring seats and the saddle stays and all those stuff. That's another part. Next is the look part. A lot of people modified their Java to look like something else. They wanted their Java to look like a scrambler. They wanted their Java to look like a cafe racer. They wanted their Java to look different. Okay, people were playing around with seats, the colors and the mud guards and the headlights, handlebar, bar end mirrors, and so many things. This is what Java did, or rather the folks. So what the folks over at Classic Legends Private Limited actually did is basically take all the learnings from this people who have been doing experiments, I mean, all of us post on social media, be it on Instagram, Facebook or whatever. So they took all these learnings and they put it into these two new bikes, which is Roadster and the Scrambler. That is exactly my personal opinion. This is what it should have been with Java 2.0. Okay, these two bikes should have come as disguised as Java 2.0 and not those the bike which was launched as 2.1, which had blacked out thing and three new colors and all those things. Those could have been cosmetic facelift kind of a thing, but this is what ideally should have been launched as Java 2.0 or Java 3.0. I mean, as a company, CLPL, or as a brand which is Java or ESD, I know they have their own mathematics to work on, business to run, and people to feed. So they made a decision to take all these learnings, put it into a bike or a two, and launch it as a brand new bike. Okay, that's exactly what I feel. The seat, what you see in Roadster, that's been something that's not new. That has been something which lots of people, I'm going and exaggerate and tell that hundreds of people have on their Java 42 or Java Classic. The handlebar, yes, a lot of people have already had it and posted on Instagram and Facebook. And when it comes to a Scrambler, the Scrambler look is not something very new. Lot of people had done it. I personally have to give a special mention to the folks from Kerala, the Jin brothers, as I would like to call it. He's into bike modification, and in fact, like, he has got the attention from even the Java bosses as well, or rather the Classic Legends bosses as well. He's done a tremendous job of modifying Java 42, and he has done like almost like 4 or 5 bikes, or maybe even more, but such a unique, good looking, balanced bikes that he has. And I was personally very, very impressed with one of his latest one, wherein he's made the customer's Java 42 look like a Scrambler. The whole paint scheme, the whole look and feel, the suspension, the tires, the mudguard, everything looks perfect. I mean, personally, I loved it. And what SD have done it here, or what Classic Legends have done here, is just take that idea and put it into a bike and call it as SD Scrambler. I mean, this could have been a Java Scrambler, this could have been a Java Roadster, but I don't understand what makes them launch it under a new motorcycle name. Now, this also makes me think, what about Java next? Like, what will happen to Java motorcycle? Will there be really an innovation wherein we'll get to see new type of bikes, or new segment of bikes? Maybe twin, maybe higher capacity, whatever. There were a lot of rumors about SD coming in with 600 or 650cc and twin and all those things. And I was pretty sure those were all like bullshit rumors right from the word go. So I was personally expecting SD Road King being launched. And unfortunately, that didn't happen. I don't know if they have plans for it in future, but I don't know. I don't have much hopes about it. So that's where I think the Classic Legends strategy is something which is not very impressive, is what I feel. Like, this could have been Java 2.0, or this could have been Java 3.0, and they could have released something else for the SD brand. Maybe the Adventure also, that is fine, but it's not at all impressive. Like, what's new in this? I mean, it's exactly the same Parak engine. So if Java had released these two bikes, right, so it would have been like there were at least like five options for the customers to choose from, which is Classic, 42, Parak, Roadster and Scrambler. Probably they could have kept the Scrambler and Roadster around that Parak segment, which is the 330cc. But I mean, it's really difficult to imagine why they went for this strategy or these type of thing, like not a new engine, not something new when it comes to the looks. The quality is something which is very debatable here, because I can openly say that the classic Legends or Java were not very famous for their very high quality of components that were used. I've heard and seen numerous cases of people having issues with their engine oil leaking, people having issues with their suspension, people having issues with their tank, the fuel injector system, so many things, quite a lot of issues. And if that thing kind of like gets cascaded over to this one also, I don't know who will really trust the Java and yes, the brand anymore. So that's exactly my thing here, my opinion here. So if I really have to tell on the engine front or the vehicle front, I have kind of like a high hopes on the SD Adventure, because on the paper it looks really fantastic. Definitely zero on the looks. I mean, I'm not somebody who's telling the Himalayan looks bad or the Adventure looks bad. It's just that the Adventure is not a new design. It doesn't look new, and it's very easy to get confused between these two vehicles. Okay, but on paper it looks really good, and I hope that unlike Java, at least SD, with SD rather, they give out review bikes to folks, and we are able to get to know about what the plus and minus of the Adventure bike, and also about the other two bikes as well. Because if you go back in time, the very first version of Himalayan was not the best version. So the very first version almost kind of like hit a nail on the coffin for the Himalayan bike, but the way it has come back is really something which is commendable. The current BS6 Avatar, the one which got launched even in 2021, that looks pretty decent. But again, the power wise it is very underpowered. I would not say very underpowered, for a 411cc bike it is definitely underpowered at 24 PS. So I mean, in fact, like they are coming up with variants, as we already know. There is a Himalayan Scram that is coming up, which is exactly the same engine, that 411cc engine, but this is more of like a road focused or a city focused vehicle with equal front and back tires. And there has already been public announcement about the Himalayan 450 that's coming up probably, I think, in the next year, which is a brand new engine, brand new chassis and brand new segment altogether. And thirdly, there is already an official confirmation about the Himalayan 650, which is basically a adventure tourer based on the 650cc twin cylinder engine that RE already has. So at this point of time, as of today, or rather as of the next 1 to 2 years, the SD Adventure will directly compete with the existing Himalayan, or probably, or I'm telling you, or probably with the Himalayan 450. The KTM 390 Adventure is pretty, it's made this mark felt, and it is sitting pretty solid there. And a lot of people have been choosing that over a Himalayan because of all the power and all those feature things. But if the SD Adventure is able to live up to its specs, then I'm pretty sure they have at least one winner out here. There's just one. I'm just talking about SD Adventure. I'm like kind of like not impressed with their strategy with the Scrambler and Roadster here. So let's see how things go by. Personally, I have not yet gone to the showrooms and seen any of these bikes. I've been getting a lot of photos and videos from some of my friends who have been going to their nearest showrooms and checking out. Looks like in most places it is a Scrambler which is put up for display. So let it come. I'm not really interested, but maybe I'll definitely do a test drive of the SD Adventure, but definitely won't be buying that. because I have different things on my mind, both when it comes to this bike and what could potentially be my next bike in future and whenever I buy that. So this the adventure is definitely not on my cards. Talking about the Scrambler, yesterday a few people commented out like what made the designer think that that inclined seat would look good. I found it very strange. I don't know how comfortable it is to sit for long and ride on that bike, but it seems like it was done with a purpose, but I don't see any. I mean, I might be wrong, but I don't see any purpose in that strange. A flat bench seat would have been very good. And again, going back to my reference of the Scrambler built by the Custom Rider Studio in Kerala, that looks awesome. I mean, they could have come at least close to it. And I did see a couple of folks on the social media, I mean, quote unquote, the influencers, even they had put some screenshots with a few, I would say, like sketches on top of the Scrambler side profile telling that the seat should have been like this, the exhaust should have been like that. So that outright says that maybe they did it in a hurry, these two bikes, especially the Roadster and Scrambler, or they did it just because they wanted to do it. I mean, my personal opinion, as I always already told you, this is what the Java 3.0 should have been, but I don't know what's next. So that's what I want to tell. Another thing that it caught my attention when I was seeing the videos, the first impression videos last evening, was the fit and finish, the quality of finish wise, still that is something which is not very impressive. I mean, this I'm seeing on a video on YouTube, but the Scrambler exhaust, the weld looked very unprofessional, or like the quality check is like not up to the mark. And when it comes to the close-up of the tank of the SD Adventure, it looked very mediocre. I don't want to name which particular magazine or YouTube channel it was, but some of them did give a very good close-up of the tank, and the paint finish was looking very, very mediocre. I mean, you can compare it. I mean, you can't even compare it with what the Generation 2 or 2.0 of Java looks like. It was really that bad. I don't know. I mean, is it just the display bikes which are like that, or the final bikes will be looking good and all? That only time will tell. But even on our bikes, the weld quality and the weld finishing was not really up to the mark. And I hope they have corrected it. Hope the folks at Java/SD/Classic Legends Private Limited have corrected all these things. Interesting thing that I have been seeing from this morning was that a lot of people who own the current gen Java 42, after seeing the Scrambler, what they've been telling is that if and when these accessories are available in the market, they're telling that they'll pick up just these accessories and put it on their Java 42, and that will do the job for them, be it the mudguard, the fly screen, or the handle, or whatever, even the alloy wheel for that matter. They're telling that they'll just pick up the act. Now, coming to the accessories also, SD has been promising and showcasing a lot of accessories for all these three bikes, especially for the Adventure. So many things: the crash guard, the tank guard, aux light, jerry can holders and top boxes, panniers, so many things. They have like they just put every single thing, whatever they could think of, on that bike, and they were marketing it. Even the Scrambler has Scrambler and the Roadster have a lot of things which are been told that they'll be available as accessories. But that is one another point which I'm extremely disappointed when it comes to the Java, because right from the word day one, they had been promoting so many of those accessories on social media, especially, and even on their website to that matter. Even today, if you go, there are a lot of accessories which are still listed. And the worst part is that we never got to see them in person at all in any of the service center. I think there was like one batch of these accessories sent to each and every service center which was available then, and after that it was never available at all. Okay, and what the service centers basically did is they got this replicated from their own vendors and they started selling it, because the quality of the ones which were actually from the Java factory were not up to the mark. And there were a lot better ones which started coming from third-party companies, like be it from Xana and all those folks. They had better accessories for Java and Java Classic and the Java 42 compared to what Java themselves had. Quite a long time, they were marketing jackets, none of which came to the market. For quite a long time, they were marketing the saddlebags, the canvas or leather kind of saddlebags. Never, whenever I asked it in any of the service centers or showrooms in Bangalore, everybody told we don't know, we don't know. And the social media handle is like, those are all like automated response or absolutely no at all. So I'm not too optimistic about the accessories that has already been marketed by SD to be available and to be of the best quality. But once the bike is out, I'm pretty sure it's just a matter of weeks, if not for months, by when a lot of companies will come up with their own set of accessories. But again, this depends on how well the bike is. I'm pretty sure these guys will keep an eye on the reviewers also. And if the reviewers say that the bike is good and it performs well and all, that means that more people will buy it. And if more people buy it, of course, there will be a market for these accessories. So that's how it will cascade down. Again, it all depends on the test drives and how well the bike, forget about the test rides, it's all how well the bike performs and all those things. By the time I finished talking and wind up this video, I think it became dark and I just had a little bit of work, so just took a break there. So all that I want to summarize is, before picking up your bike, do your own due diligence. Okay, it's not just limited to test drive. Read a little bit about the bike. I mean, if it is already there in the market for some time, read a little bit about the brand. More specifically, try to speak to folks who already have the bike or have bikes from that particular company, and also go through a few forums like XPHP or something similar. Just go through that, try to see what is their general feedback. Okay, and more specifically, try to see if you can join some Telegram or WhatsApp groups which are specific to these particular bikes. It's not that people don't do all these things, but again, especially with this particular brand, I see that there is a lot of fanboyism. Okay, and people, even if you sugarcoat and give something else, people are ready to take. So this is kind of like my small way of telling that, okay, be careful about what you're picking up, because at the end of the day, it's your hard-earned money. And on top of it, it's a vehicle that you will use probably day in and day out, probably for your commute or for your travel or for your adventures or for whatever reason. So you need to build that connection with the bike, you need to enjoy it. So that's exactly the reason why I made this video, so that you understand what is my perspective about it. And if you're able to read in between the lines, then I think you're mature enough. If not, I think there is always next time, and you'll get well soon, don't worry about it. Alright, that's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. And if there is any specific question that you want to ask, feel free to do so in the comment section below. I'm decently or fairly active even on Instagram as well. So if you are into Instagram kind of a stuff, then you can follow me there as well under the same name, Creator on Wheels. So until we catch again, see you, take care, be safe. Things have not gone yet. So take care and stay safe. Bye bye. Mati Sigana.